Hi, I'm Jake Lett. Thank you for downloading my logo slider module. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add it to your page and start using it. So let's get started. In HubSpot, when editing a page, there's a navigation on the left-hand side. Click on this plus sign, and you'll notice that there's these two tabs, modules, sections, and layouts. So you can filter through these different tabs or different modules, but a quick way to find the one that we're talking here about here is a logo slider is just by searching for it by name. So all my modules have a prefix of Jake, so you can either do it that way by search my name. So if you search logo slider, I have two here just because this is a development environment, but this is the one that you're going to be looking for, the Jake logo slider. And I'm going to click on this and drag it over, and you'll see these this turquoise or green color that lets you know that when you let go, it's going to drop it in that place. So you could move it to the left or the right, but in this case, I just want it below this heading text. Once you add the module to your page, you'll notice that I have some default images in there, just so you can see how it works. And if you click on this arrow here, you can kind of see at the below there are these little dots, and this blue indicator just shows what image that you're on. But since we're using the same image, it's hard to kind of see what's happening. So I'm going to delete all these and start fresh. So currently I have no images in place. So I'm going to do add one and replace the default image. And I'm just going to use these thumbnail images that I have for my modules. So I'm going to use this one. Go back, add a new one. Go back, hit add, place, view object. Image, add another one. I'm gonna do five here, so one more. Okay, so now that we have five images in place, I'm gonna scroll down and see what settings that we have for each image that we add to them. We can obviously select the image that we want. We can adjust the alt text. And then for size, right now it's gonna say the exact width and height. So whatever I have the image as already, so 960 by 720. And you can add a link to the image. That is an option that you can have. But for in this case, I just want to have just a basic image slider or logo slider. So just for where we are right now, let's do a preview. And I recommend when you're editing pages, to always preview the page outside of this editor, because there's just a lot going on in here and it's hard to see the functionality fully. So I would go to preview. Open a new tab. And then here we can see what's happening. So right now it's showing the images, but it looks like they're stacked on top of each other. And it's showing two slides. So we need to make some adjustments there. So I'm gonna go back and click on the module. And we're gonna look for the preset settings. And I'm going to select this just so you can see what it is. So show scroll bar. If I click on that and apply, you'll see this little scroll bar at the bottom. So you can choose between what navigation you want. You can either have the scroll bar here, these dots, or these left and right arrows. And you can use all of them at once, or you just choose which one you want to have in your design. In my case, I'm just going to do the left and right navigation and the dots. That's what I prefer. So that's why I have here, show navigation dots, show arrows, and I'm gonna do loop scroll. So that will say when it gets to the end, it's gonna go back to the beginning. And I have autoplay. You can adjust the speed. So 1,000 milliseconds equals 1 second. So that's why it's gotta be set in milliseconds. So right here, this is gonna be 2.5 seconds. So if I wanna make it, you know, 3 seconds, you would just do 30, so 3,000 is 3 seconds. Space between just shows that there's a gap between the images. And for desktop, I want to have 4 images, and then I want to have 2 on mobile. So one of the issues that we're seeing is that the image is taking the width of the image, and it's not scaling to fit the available space. So that was a mistake I did when I was editing these images. And if I click on the edit for the image, you'll see the size is saying exact width and height. What I wanted to do is I wanted to automatically adjust to the width of this that I specify. So as I make this page responsive and scale to the width of the window, I want the images to get smaller as well. So I'm going to do automatically adjust and then apply. And I need to do that for all the images here. So I'll do that really quickly. All right, so I have that setting made, and so now I'm going to hit apply changes, and we should see the images get responsive and scale down to fit the available space. So I'm going to hit apply changes. And I'm going to open up my preview page that I had open and refresh it. And then when I preview the image, you'll see that on desktop it's going to be 4, and as you get smaller, it's going to go down to 2, and then on mobile, it's going to be 1. Let's close that and go back to my editor screen. And there's some other settings that you can change as well. So we're going to do disable animation on interaction. So what that means is someone hovers over the image, it's going to stop scrolling. And I can also do grayscale on interaction. So if I apply that, it's going to be grayscale by default, and on when I hover over it, it's going to be a color. So I'm going to go back to my other tab in preview, refresh that, and you'll see if I hover over them, they go in full color. But by default, they will be grayscale. So this is sometimes you might want to do this when you have like a lot of logos and they're just all different colors and it's clashing with your brand colors. This is one way I would recommend doing that. You could just do grayscale and then color on hover. So those are the main settings. There's also some style options where we can adjust the coloring of these navigation elements. So you can adjust all those colors there and also the spacing between them. If you have any questions that I didn't cover in this video, if you scroll down, there's a form that you can fill out with your question, and I'll reply as soon as I can to help you. Thank you very much, and I appreciate you downloading my module. Have a great day. Are you looking for someone to help you improve and optimize your HubSpot website or blog? Check out my SEO optimization service by visiting jakeseo.com.